do with the rest of the salad?
Oh, just put it in here and I'll take it home to Grandma and watch you faint. I tell her I get all my nutrients from Shirley's gum.
Sure you're not mad?
About?
We would have eaten whatever you fixed. The extra food was just a
safety precaution. Yeah. Like life jackets on a boat.
Did Emily tell you we were bringing stuff?
Ugh. When you walk into a room and people stop whispering, after a few times, you kind of get the hint that something's going on.
How did you know what was that?
You don't think you can hide anything from me. You know I can take one look at you and know what you're thinking.
Okay, so what am I thinking right now?
Well, that Nicholas is shaping up to be a pretty cool brother, but you wish he hadn't eaten the last of those big New York pretzels, because ever since our trip, they're your new favorite breakfast food, and you had your eye on them for the morning.
Elizabeth, I do occasionally have thoughts that aren't about food.
Well, you thought it sometime, but I know all about safety precautions, too. You think you want them?
Oh, yeah.
No,
you can get enough. Yeah. Come on, let me have them. Please, please, this is from New York.
Take them. Fine, take them now. The next day, I'll tickle you.
You should have one here.
Hey, cowboy.
Thought that was your back walking away.
Yeah, I just left the club and my feet brought me here. I'm just, walking.
Bet you're wondering why we're closed, huh?
Well, no, I seem to remember you asking permission for a private party.
Just a little one.
Actually, it's over now. Why don't you come in?
Oh, no, thanks. Nah, I'm fed and it's a nice night for a walk.
What if I want you to?
Well, I usually try to only go where I'm not wanted. But I guess I could make an exception.
You'll have to excuse me, but I have some cleaning to do.
Sure.
Thank you. Oh, man.
Oh, I'm seeing this. This is nice. I like that. Very cool.
Yeah.
It looks like a change for a payphone in Sweden.
It's an old New York subway token. Oh. Elizabeth.
That's all right. I wasn't trying to be nosy or anything.
No, we want to move to Manhattan when she gets accepted to art school.
It's expensive living there.
And people do it.
Yeah, well, what people do, you can do better. Well, this is good. I'm very, happy for you. You know, you found the real deal. First time out the chute. Congratulations, cowboy.
Hey, Dad, if you had it all to do again, knowing what you know now.
What do I know? I'd be afraid to do it again, tell you the truth. I might really screw it up. I might try to raise you.
You have more to do with who I am and who I'm going to be the rest of my life than anyone. In fact, I didn't even know who I was, separate from you. Until my only choice was finding out. But I'm back. And yeah, a lot's changed. But I found new things to call the best in you. And they're not pictures in my head this time. They're real. What I want to say is that Lulu needs that too. What we had. I know because of me. Because of all that stuff I said to you. The way I made you hurt. You may be thinking you're sparing her something much worse by keeping your distance, but she'd be the loser. And I'd be the reason. I can't handle that, Dad. She loves you. She misses you. I mean, she thinks you are the strongest, the best, the... And someday, she will realize, just like I did, that even if you're not, how bad can a guy with your record collection be? You probably need to go.
Yeah, probably.
If I ticked you off, I didn't mean to.
What ticked me off? You know, son, I never, ever considered myself father material. You know that. And that whole idea of role modeling, boy, that just terrifies me. Fatherhood to me was always a job that too many guys had who had no qualifications for it. I just didn't want to be another one of those guys, you know. I didn't want to perpetuate the misery and all the mistakes. But one thing leads to another. And there you were. And it wasn't a job. It was a kick. Oh, it was an incredible kick. You were always good company. You let me do what I do. You do what you do. So if you tell me that I've had something to do with the development of a man who I hold in the highest regard, well, that's a blessing. I may be taller, but you are my hero. You are the role model in this family.
How much longer do you think you can keep that taller thing going?
Oh, leave me a little dignity, will you? Hey, Elizabeth, you want to come in here and take this big lug off my hands?
Yes, please.
You know me. I can't hang out here. I got places to go and people to see.
Mm-hmm.
And I can't leave him alone with the silverware. You know that.
Take care, Dad.
I'm so proud of you. Elizabeth, if you ever get tired of this guy, you take him to a bus station or a... No, that's a subway station. You take him to a subway station, tell him to use that token, and then you call me and I'll pick him up at the end of whatever line he's riding.
Oh, well, this token's been tampered with. I don't think they'll accept it.
Bummer. Then you're stuck with him.
Well, you heard him. I guess it's official.
Can't help it. I love the guy. I never thought I'd say this and mean it, but I'm not mad at him anymore.
You forgave him.
What my dad did, he didn't do to me.
So...
I'm ashamed when I think of how I was to him, to my mom. Just heartless. They tried to explain, but I didn't want to understand. And I tried to think it through, but the more I thought, the worse it seemed. I hated them. And then everything changed. God gave me an angel named Elizabeth. And everything changed. They had this. What we have. They loved each other. They thought it was never gonna end. And it did. That's a big enough price to pay. I'm through. I'm through with the hate. I mean, they're my parents. I love them. You did that for me, Elizabeth.
Period tomorrow?
Damn. I guess that's what I get for sleeping through the first one, huh?
Well, do you want to meet me at the art supply store?
Okay.
Okay, and then maybe we can go to that estate sale that Emily clipped out of the paper.
What for?
Well, just to browse. Who knows, maybe we'll both find something that's just absolutely perfect.
For a place in New York that we don't have yet.
Oh, am I crazy? You're gonna have to be patient with me. Even planning 5 minutes ahead is all new to me. You know, I think that's why I used to smoke, so I'd have something to look forward to. Because it's not like somebody was going to call me or ask me to go out. And even if they did, I probably would have just said no with some sarcastic remark. And now here I am, at the end of a very ordinary day, and it has been filled with just lots of wonderful things. Sending the watercolor to your mom, having dinner with Emily and Nicholas, being there watching you mend things with your dad. You know, I used to tell people to get a life, and that basically meant leave me alone. But now I got one instead. Because you literally picked me up off the ground and gave it to me. Do I have something on my face?
I just wanted to touch you. Art supplies, estate sales. That's all fine and good, but first things first.
Pretzels.
You got them, I want them.
Okay, 7:30 tomorrow morning at Kelly's. I can't miss French, I'll be doomed. So go right home, don't stay up reading or playing with your computer, and then 7:30 shouldn't be a problem, okay?
Okay.
Good.
Good night.
Good night. Hey, Lucky.
You are so beautiful. I love you too, sweetie. Did I wake you up? Already?
Almost.
What are you doing?
Aren't you supposed to be sleeping?
Oh, I am. I mean, I'm in bed, but I'm not tired. I thought I'd read something real boring, like my notes for the test tomorrow. Guess what I'm doing right now?
Reading your notes?
I'm lighting one of your candles. Guess why?
Because I gave it to you.
Because it's warm and it smells good and it lights up a room just like you.
Lucky. That's so sweet. Will you light another one for me?
Are you in dreamland?
I spent the whole day in dreamland.
Me too. Elizabeth, go to sleep.
Okay. Good night.